Steve Carey, do you think media training, particularly with the work that you do, should be included in the hiring, when you hire a young journalist today? Should we be out there helping them to understand the situation overseas and how a foreign news service should be working?
I think that's a wonderful utopian view, and I'll probably be a bit controversial tonight. I don't intend to offend anyone, but I've always said I say what I think, not what I think people want to hear. So the hard news story for me is that that's a great notion, and everybody can always do better from better training, obviously. The truth is, when you're hired in a newsroom these days, newsrooms are working at absolute breakneck speed. They are flat out, they are time poor, they don't have sometimes even time to think. In a commercial newsroom when I started, I had to do one story. I was the police reporter at Channel 9. I'd start at 5 in the morning. My day was go down, do the morning briefing with the cops. It might be a murder or something like that. You'd do the press conference at 8 o'clock, go out to the scene, go to the pub on the way back, write your story. 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock, you're done. By the time I finished running the news division at 7, I had a reporter, Norm Beeman, and he was old school like me. So I'll just tell you a brief story about how things have changed. Norm was like me, he only had one story to do at the start. By the time I finished, we tracked down, or Norm tracked down, Tony Mockbell, England father. And that was the biggest story of the day. And to this day, that's one of the best stories we've covered. But I can just tell you that when Norm went, we didn't tell anyone he was going. He just went. So when we were there lucky enough to get him, Norm's day started with a live cross into Channel 7 that night, because the first thing as the news broke was everybody was on the phone to me saying, what are you going to do? It's your patch. You better get a reporter there. And I was happy to say, we've already got a reporter there because we were lucky enough to know him. He did the live cross into Sunrise. He backed it up with 11 a.m. news. He backed it up with promos. He then did radio stories. He had to write copy. He had to do 4:30 news. He had to back it up for 6 o'clock news, a live cross and a package. And because we had Today Tonight in those days, he then had to still be on deck 12 hours later doing a live cross. So all I'm saying is I think it's a wonderful notion. More knowledge is key in anything we do. Me coming here tonight is an indication that I'm also an old dog, but I want to learn. I want to communicate. I want to know and understand different communities. That's what I want for my kids. I think where we fail a little bit still in the media is in a commercial TV news sense, there are still guys like me running news services. So I'm a product of my upbringing, right?
And they're still hiring, correct?
And still hiring. So the more we can do to change that dynamic and bring that sort of diversity into a newsroom, and I do think it's changing, not as fast as some would like, but it is changing. And I will just reference very quickly